Hello my friends and welcome back to another video here on Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your host, Jared Bronstein, and today we're talking hurricanes. Before we get into it, do make sure you are subscribed and hit that bell notification. If you enjoy the video, let us know by giving it a thumbs up and of course, drop some comments below with your thoughts on the video. So Hurricane Dorian, a Category 5 hurricane which is being considered one of the most intense hurricanes of our time. It's reached winds at 185 miles per hour on landfall, tying the Labor Day hurricane of 1935, and is only second to Hurricane Allen, who reached 190 miles per hour in 1980. According to the Washington Post, it's the strongest storm on record east of Florida and north of the Caribbean. If you've turned on the news, you could see it's absolutely destroying parts of the Bahamas and is getting stronger as it heads to Florida. As of now, it's a Category 5, which is the max level for hurricanes. But we decided to question what would happen if Dorian turned into a Category 6 hurricane. Before we explain what would happen if Dorian hit a Category 6, let's talk about what categories are. According to the Saffir-Simpson Hurricane Wind Scale, a Category 1 hurricane is a hurricane with sustained winds of 74 to 95 miles per hour and could cause some damage due to dangerous winds. Based off of this scale, the categories increase as the winds and dangers intensify. The categories go up per 20 miles per hour, so a Category 2 would be winds of 96 to 110 miles per hour, and so on. For a hurricane to officially hit a category, it has to sustain these winds for at least 1 minute. According to the National Hurricane Center and Central Pacific Hurricane Center, a major Category 5 hurricane would reach 157 miles per hour or higher and, I quote, catastrophic damage will occur. A high percentage of framed homes will be destroyed, with total roof failure and wall collapse. Fallen trees and power poles will isolate residential areas. Power outages will last for weeks to possibly months. Most of the area will be uninhabitable for weeks or months. End quote. It's believed there are currently talks about adding a Category 6 to the scale, and if they decided to add it, well technically, Dorian would be a Category 6. Assuming that a Category 6 would be a hurricane with winds sustained at 178 to 198 miles per hour, Dorian, as well as a few other previous Category 5s, would be moved up. But here's why the category scale is a bad indication of how serious a storm is. It only focuses on the maximum wind speeds lasting for at least a minute, not taking into consideration other factors that determine how destructive a hurricane can be. A good example would be Hurricane Katrina, which was the costliest storm in US history. It was a Category 3 storm when it hit land, took the lives of an estimated 1,200 people, and cost the US an estimated $108 million in property damage. But again, this was a Category 3 storm. So what would happen if Dorian became a Category 6 hurricane? Well, technically, it already is, and although it's being considered a Category 5, that's because, as previously mentioned, a Category 5 is any hurricane with winds exceeding 157 miles per hour. But as you could see, currently, the category scale of hurricanes only focuses on maximum wind speeds, even though it should also consider things like total rainfall or rainfall over time. Now before I continue, let me be very clear. I'm not saying Dorian isn't a serious hurricane by any means. As of now, it's believed it's claimed the lives of approximately 7 people, has destroyed tons of homes, and left many people stranded. It's still a very serious storm and shouldn't be taken lightly based off of what I just said. It's a Category 5 storm for a reason and should be treated accordingly. As of now, it's unclear whether or not a Category 6 will ever be added. Some believe it should, while others say anything Category 5 is so catastrophic, there's no need to add another category beyond it. However, other scales are now being developed to help determine how destructive a storm could potentially be. James Dunn, a scientist at the National Center for Atmospheric Research in Colorado, has been working on a project for a few years called the Cyclone Damage Potential Index, which considers storm size and its forward speed, both factors in how destructive the storm could be. However, he's made it clear it would just measure the potential of how destructive it could be, and that it shouldn't replace the Saffir-Simpson Hurricane Wind Scale, but instead be used alongside it. As always, we love hearing from you, so please do drop us some comments right down below with your thoughts on the whole situation, as well as this video. Do you think there should be a Category 6 hurricane? Let us know in the comments below. But for now, let's respond to some comments from the video. What would happen if you fell into quicksand? JC Mendoza said, "What would happen if you fell in quicksand? Me. You die. After watching this video. Me. Oh. Turns out, it's kind of impossible to die. I mean, if you watch the video, you'd understand. Maybe, like, you could drown if a current came over you, but just by literally standing in quicksand, it's impossible." Larry Collier said, "If two vegetarians fight, wouldn't that be beyond beef?" I see what you did there. I don't know. I guess, because I don't eat beef. But is it beyond? Like, wouldn't it just be like two vegetables fighting? I don't know. Oba Baba Tunde, I think I said that right, said, "I was walking in a river and I walked into some quicksand, and since it was underwater, it was pretty dangerous, but luckily, it was only a few centimeters deep, so I was fine." Well, I'm happy to hear you're okay. Still must have been pretty scary. Like, I won't lie, if I were to ever step into quicksand, I would still be scared, even though I would know what to do now because of the video I did on this channel. Pro tip, you just lean back and your body should float to the top. But still, it'd be very scary to step into something and slowly going down because, you know, it's just having no control. I don't know. I would freak out, but that's just me. Anyways, guys, that does it for this video. As always, you got to be sure to let us know in the comments down below your thoughts on this video. And if you think they should add a category 6 to the hurricane scale, be sure to like this video if you enjoyed it, share it with a friend, and of course, subscribe to our channel so you guys never miss a video. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein, and we'll see you guys in the next video.